Hey everyone, hope you're doing well today. Trancherdan here. I'm going to be doing a very quick video to tell you a little story, I guess, about this spider which has escaped. So this is my Chromatopalmus cyanopubescens, the green bottle blue, or GBB for short. And this spider actually escaped. I've obviously caught it now, and I'm going to be rehousing it back into its enclosure. I don't actually know how it got out. I fed it and I thought I locked it all up, there's no sort of holes anywhere, but it has somehow managed to get out still. And yeah, what happened was, last week I came back, I've been out with my girlfriend, and the actual spider was on the plugs, just here. And I glanced over my shoulder and noticed that my girlfriend was sort of getting ready for bed and things, so I figured I'd have enough time to get into this cupboard down here where I keep my spare tubs to get it to capture it. And when I came back up, the spider had gone. And what it's actually done, I don't know if you'll be able to see it underneath this, my P. metallica enclosure, it's actually webbed up and has built like a bit of a nest kind of underneath there. So I ended up leaving it for a few days, and then my girlfriend came around again a few days later, and again getting ready for bed, and it was out in the open and I managed to catch it. And I haven't seen this spider for a while because it's usually in this burrow, so I figured I'd do a quick video to show you. And my girlfriend is not really a fan of spiders. She sort of tolerates them, I guess. She likes them so long as they're sort of locked away, and actually prefers true spiders to tarantulas, so I might get some more true spider stuff to add to my collection. And yeah, my girlfriend has named this spider Louise. I don't know why, that's the name that she thinks suits it best. So I thought I'd just do a quick video to tell you that funny little story. I actually told my girlfriend in the morning, because I thought if I did a video about it and she saw it, she'd be kind of freaking out. So I was like, just to let you know, spider escaped, but don't worry, I've caught it now, and it was only out for like a week. So she did see the funny side of it, to be fair, and didn't. But you know, didn't really mind. So yeah, this is the Chromatopalmus cyanopubescens, and I haven't really seen it that much because it's always in there. And I'm gonna very carefully try and see if I can get it to go in. Hopefully it will. Might as well just leaving it. Come on. Is kind of coming. Come on. Very carefully. Here we go. I'm trying to not. Obviously, I don't want to hurt her. Just trying to get her to come out. Actually, I have some tweezers here, so I might be just using these. These are handy. Come on. There we go. I should have done that to begin with, to be fair. So yeah, here you go, a quick story for you, and putting her back into her enclosure. You can see she's got loads of room in there, so she should find her the entrance to her web, and she'll be quite happy. So yeah, and I apologise for the lack of videos. I've said in previous videos I've got a few things sort of going on privately at the moment. To be fair, Becky, my partner, is very encouraging of me to do more videos. So I will try and get some more done when I have the time and things. So yeah, I apologise for the lack of videos, but you know, I hope you'll look forward to the ones I'll be doing in the future. I have quite a few more to do, including. Make sure I use this. I'll be doing a video of a recent molt. This enclosure needs to be emptied out because it's I sprayed it a lot recently, as you can see. So this has all got to come out, but the molt is up on the top there, and this is a mature male. So I'll be doing a video to show you that, and to also sort of show you how I do tarantula maintenance with regard to, sort of mushrooms and mould, fungi and things. So anyways, thanks for watching everyone, hope you've enjoyed this quick video, and I'll speak to you all soon in the next video.